Hey guys, welcome to thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. We are the Great Outdoors RV at thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. My name is Mate, and today we're checking out the Wildwood X Lite. This is a cool unit because it's one of the unfortunate parts is we did have a hailstorm that came through and we did get some hail damage. I want to show you that. Because of that, we have this drastically reduced. You can click on the link in the description and that will take you to our pricing that we have on this one. Start off, the dry weight on this is 5,000 pounds, 5,002 pounds to be exact. And so that's going to be very lightweight for most of your half-ton trucks out there and things of similar nature. This is a power front tongue jack. This is diamond plate front here. You have two 20-pound propane bottles. This is a power awning, and then this is a solar port. So if you decide to add a solar panel, you can do that to charge your batteries. This has electric stabilizer jacks. So you just push a button for those to go up and down. And then as you can see, this also has a pass-through storage. Let me show you how that awning works. Give me 1 second. These are the nice solid steps right here. So these are a little bit more sturdy than most. And then if you want that awning to come out, you have a remote. So you can either do that by pushing a button or you can control it with this remote. So let me select what we're gonna go for, let it boot up, and then awning out. So you can just push a button for that to go out. You can also push a button for the stabilizer jacks to go down. And this has a slide out. So come on over here with me. And I'll show you, if I wanted to select the slide out, I can push this in or out by just pushing a button. So if there's a tree that's really close or a power line or your neighbor camper, it's a lot easier to be doing this from this side than inside your coach. So that's a super nice feature. This is also a tandem axle, so it's going to pull a lot smoother than a single axle. You'll notice you also have outside speakers. And then these are cool too. You have like little lights that you can turn on and out off from in here too. Come on inside. As you can see, that slide out really opens up this entire unit. Now, some people, when I first mentioned the idea of a Murphy bed, it throws them off. They're like, oh, set up and tear down. That takes way too much time. But the beauty of something this size is one of the ways they give you this much room and not have a bed take up a lot of your room is this Murphy bed idea. So a lot of people are really liking that. And after they see how easy it is to work, they can see that it takes all of seconds to set up and tear down, so to speak. There you go. And then it has a lock right over here. So if you want it to get back up, you just pull that lock. And that's all there is to it. As you can see, this also has some storage that you can access from either side or from the outside. As you can see, that's the door that you can get to the outside. You also have some hanging space. You also have a good size window right here. This is an emergency exit window that you can actually open. Blackout shades, which are a little bit nicer. Double sink, so you get enough room to work inside and have your washing and your drying, and high-rise sink faucet. You do have an oven in here. A lot of guys will leave that out at this price point. And again, this one is marked way down because of that hailstorm. This folds up so that you have a nice backsplash. And then you have more storage underneath here, some drawers to work with. Microwave, this is a 110 refrigerator, so this can run off both gas and electric. And look at the size of this pantry. This is one of the better sized pantries on a coach this size, which is pretty awesome. This is where you'd put a TV. Now it does not come with a TV, but you can add one right there. And then this also turns into a bed. So if you needed an extra sleeping place, this table basically folds down to here with taking out these little rungs. And then you use these cushions to fill in that blank space. All right, and then if that wasn't enough storage already, you'll notice that you have a second pantry on this side too. Digital thermostat that you're working with. And then while we're talking about storage, check out how much hanging space you have in here. So again, this is actually an amazing amount of storage, all hidden hinges throughout for the coach. And then you also have a medicine cabinet here, more storage down here, a linen closet over here. Gosh, I feel like that's the story of this camper is storage. And then this is a glass instead of a shower curtain only. And it's this neo angled type deal where it's a little bit more room. And you also have the skylight above you too. So all LED lights throughout here, the slide out, again, aggressively priced, and a ducted air conditioning. So if you want to be able to point this a certain direction, you can do that. And the ducting air will cool down your unit a lot more evenly. All right, guys, thanks for checking out this Wildwood 233RBXL. If you have any questions, feel free to reach us at thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. We are just about an hour north of Denver, and feel free to comment. We love answering any kind of questions. If you like the video, please hit the like button. That really helps me out. And then if you need any help with financing or trade-ins, anything like that, just give us a holler, 970-313-4337. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.